In previous lectures, we have solved numericals related to vapor compression refrigeration system. Now the theory part of this module, we have different components of vapor compression refrigeration cycle like compressor, condenser, cooling tower, expansion device, evaporators and refrigerants. So we will see one by one the different parts and refrigerants as well, what are the different types and so on. So today we will mostly cover compressor, condenser and cooling towers. Okay, now why is compressor required in vapor compression refrigeration system? What is the function of compressor? Compressor compresses vapor refrigerant which is coming from evaporator, which is at low pressure, low temperature, to high pressure, high temperature vapor. Why is this required? So that there is circulation of refrigerant in the cycle. Okay, and once the vapor is compressed, that heat, it is rejected where? In the condenser. So whatever heat is picked up in evaporator, that is rejected in condenser. Now there are different types of compressor. Okay, now talking about the compressors, based on working principle, we have two types. First is positive displacement and second one is rotodynamic. In positive displacement, we have reciprocating compressor. Second, we have rotary type sliding vane. Third, we have rotary screw type. It can be single screw, it can be twin screw. Then we have orbital compressor, acoustic compressor. We won't be covering acoustic compressor. Then in rotodynamic type, we have radial and axial flow type. Okay. Now this is based on working principle, positive displacement or rotodynamic type. Second type, it is based on arrangement of compressor motor or external drive. Now that compressor, it is power consuming device, right? So that compressor, in order to make that compressor run, either you require some diesel engine outside or maybe some petrol engine or maybe a electrical motor. Okay, so based on the arrangement of the motor, there are three types. One is open type, second is hermetic or sealed type, and third one is semi-hermetic or semi-sealed type. Okay, now what is the meaning of this open type? We will see here itself. Open type meaning compressor is there and electrical motor is there. So motor is running the compressor. So suppose this is the shaft of the electrical motor. On that, here you will have some arrangement. Then this is suppose shaft of compressor. Here also you will have some arrangement and there will be some belt arrangement will be there or gearing arrangement will be there, and using that the electrical motor drives the compressor. Now here it is important to note that in open type, electrical motor, it is separate, and compressor, it is separate. They are not inside a single casing. Okay, so you can see the motor from outside, you can see the compressor from outside, and even you can see the belt arrangement. Now this type of arrangement is there in our college lab. Okay, if you visit the IC engine lab, there a compressor is also kept. That compressor is open type. Now in case of reciprocating compressor, if you consider this open type, it is reciprocating compressor. There you can have single stage, multi-stage. Okay, and if multi-stage is there, we can have intercooling as well. So suppose this is one cylinder, and here we have piston, here we have piston. So this piston, it will reciprocate inside this cylinder. This piston, it will reciprocate inside this cylinder. And discharge of first cylinder, there might be some intercooling arrangement, and then it will go to the inlet of second compressor. So like this, in reciprocating, we can have multi-cylinder as well, with intercooling, without intercooling, and so on. So different types are there. Now this is all about open type. Hermetically sealed, we will see in the next slide. Then according to number of working strokes, we can have single acting and double acting. What is meaning of the single acting? Single acting means that gas, it acts only on one side of the piston, and double acting means that gas acts on both the sides of the piston. So simultaneously, if you consider double acting, if one side there is compression, other side there might be expansion stroke of the compressor. It will be like that. Okay, so it is single acting and double acting. Next, number of stages. Okay, so as I have discussed here, this is single stage. One cylinder is there. If there are two cylinders, it will become multi-stage compression. With it might be intercooling. Now intercooling, there will be different types. Okay, next one, according to method of drive employed. So it can be direct drive or belt driven. So here I have show you example of belt driven. It can be direct drive also. Okay, now the most important type of compressor is hermetically sealed compressors. Okay, this type of compressor you mostly see in small units. What do you mean by small units? Domestic refrigerator. What is this domestic? Household. Okay, so household refrigerator, window AC, split AC. There we will see hermetically sealed compressor. Now, what is meaning of this hermetically sealed compressor? Compressor and motor operate on same shaft and are enclosed in a common casing. Now we will come back to this slide after we see the hermetically sealed compressor. Okay, we will see the construction first. Now as you know, there are different industries. Okay, there are different manufacturers of compressors, and mostly China is the supplier. Okay, global supplier, if you see, China is the major supplier. Now there are many big industries. Like one industry I like to name, Emerson is there. Okay, so Emerson, it is compressor manufacturing company. Now that Emerson company, it has online training for students, which is free. Okay, so you can basically go to Google, search Emerson, and please, if you have time, you can enroll for that course. Okay, now as we discussed before, there will be different manufacturers, and each manufacturer might have different design of compressor. Okay, so as such, compressor design is not fixed, but the principle of that compressor, it will remain same. Okay, so we will see this design. Okay, now Freon is what? It is a refrigerant. So understand the design. This outer casing, okay, it is metallic casing, and in that metallic casing we will have motor. Okay, so here there will be stator. Motor stator has been shown, and in between we have motor rotor. Okay, now what happens is, what is inlet to the compressor? Before compressor we have evaporator. Okay, I'll show evaporator over here. Suppose this is evaporator. From evaporator, what is outlet? Low temperature, low pressure refrigerant. Okay, they are calling here Freon as a refrigerant. So this, it will enter where? Compressor. Now since motor and piston cylinder arrangement, compressor, they are inside the shell. Okay, it cannot be cooled by atmospheric air. Okay, it will be cooled because this shell will be heated up, and the atmospheric air which is surrounding this shell, it will pick up the heat. Okay, so that is possible. But what happens is, large amount of heat is generated over here. Why? Because there is reciprocating motion. Okay, so this is motor, and you can see this motor, it is operating this connecting rod, and here we have piston, and this is cylinder. So this piston, it will reciprocate inside this cylinder. So you can see the direction of suction, low temperature, low pressure refrigerant. It enters from here. It picks up the heat from oil. Okay, now this oil, it is required for lubrication because here we have reciprocating motion. So there should be lubrication. So what is the function of oil? It will provide lubrication as well as it will pick up heat. Whatever heat is generated in between piston and cylinder, that is also picked up by the oil. Okay, so this refrigerant, it will cool the oil. Okay, it will keep the motor cool as well. And from here you can see, this is the suction of the compressor. So there will be suction, then suction is closed, discharge is closed, then whatever refrigerant is trapped inside, it is compressed in between the cylinder walls and the piston, and finally when the pressure is more, that valve of the discharge, this discharge valve, it will open and there will be high pressure, high temperature refrigerant gas discharge. Okay, now this gas, it will go where? In the condenser. Okay, so this is one type of design. Basically this refrigerant, it is cooling oil, it is keeping motor cool as well, and it is keeping the compressor temperature is also maintained. Okay, it is keeping compressor cool as well. Now if you see the open design, okay, open type, which I had told you before, okay, here this open type, there you might have separate fan. Okay, so fan will be there, there will be electrical motor, there will be compressor, and that compressor shaft is there, on that shaft itself there will be fan. So there will be forced convection of that fan, okay, that air will blow over the compressor. But here in hermetically sealed compressor, whatever heat is generated, it is inside this casing. Okay, that is why this refrigerant itself, it is cooling the system. Okay, but here there will be disadvantage. If you compare open type and hermetically sealed type, there is a disadvantage of this hermetically sealed compressor. Can you guess what is that? See, this low temperature refrigerant, it is picking up the heat inside this part, inside the casing. Okay, now because of that, what will happen? COP of the system, if you see hermetically sealed compressor, it will be less as compared to open system. Okay, open, this one, open type arrangement. So this also you have to remember. Next one, this is the actual latest model of the hermetically sealed compressor. Now before this, we will see what are the advantages and disadvantages of hermetically sealed. Okay, so what is the advantage? Leakage of refrigerant is prevented. Why? Because suction is there, okay, and discharge is there, everything is there inside the shell itself, and that shell, it is welded, so that is leak proof. So leakage of refrigerant is prevented. Then since the motor and compressor both are inside the shell, noise will be less, so it is less noisy. Then requires small space because of compactness. Lubrication is simple. Disadvantage is what? Motor drive cannot be repaired or maintained. Okay, so once the compressor is damaged or if it is not working, it is not like you are opening the shell, cutting and opening the shell, you are again checking what is the problem and then again welding. It's not like that. Once it is motor drive or the compressor is damaged, the whole compressor is discarded. Now what happens is, usually what this company do is, if you consider Emerson, what they do, if it is inside the warranty period, they will take back the compressor. Okay, they'll bring the compressor back to their plant, they will cut the compressor shell and they will check what is the problem and they will improve the design of the compressor. This is how it works. Okay, but that compressor, same compressor is not fitted again. They will send you new compressor if it is in warranty period. It's like that. Next, burnout windings can contaminate the whole system. So what will happen if by chance the winding gets burned? So what will happen now, if you see this diagram, here we have windings. Okay, if these windings are burned, what will happen? This refrigerant, it is in contact with the winding, na? So it refrigerant will get contaminated. Because of that, the whole system will be contaminated. And what is the solution for this? The whole system requiring the system to be entirely pumped down, and gas needs to be replaced. So complete refrigerant needs to be replaced. The motor winding is in direct contact with refrigerant. Hence, only those refrigerants which have high dielectric strength can be used in hermetic compressors. Okay, this also point is important. And next point, the COP of hermetic compressors is lower than open compressors. Why? Because part of refrigeration effect is lost in cooling the motor and compressor. This point we had discussed before also. Okay, now see this diagram, and can anyone explain what is this exactly? Okay, so I'll discuss this diagram. Here you can see this tube. It is welded or braced to this shell, outer shell. So this is suction, this is discharge. Okay, now that gas, it will enter over here, okay, inside. Then bottom side, this will be oil sump. And you can see there is a tube inside this oil sump. So this will be oil pickup tube. So from here that oil is picked up, and wherever lubrication is required, there will be a small hole, and that oil, it will be sent to that location. Okay, now this, you can see this is connecting rod. Okay, here there will be crankshaft, this is piston, and this portion, this is cylinder, this is piston, which reciprocates inside the cylinder. This is cylinder head. Here you will have wall arrangement, gasket as well. Okay, and bottom side, here you can see springs are there. Why is this spring given over here? Because this is reciprocating compressor, right? And that direction is horizontal. So because of reciprocating motion, there will be vibration. So to absorb that vibration, here you can see springs are provided on the bottom side. Okay. Now we'll see the different components. So here it will be clear. This is the outer shell, and this is the cover of that shell. And here you can see these copper tubes. These are connected to this shell of the compressor. Okay, so that is why we say that this is hermetically sealed. Okay, so this everything, all the components are inside this shell, and it is welded. Okay, this cover and this shell, it is welded. Now these, you can see on the shell, there are three copper tubes. What are these copper tubes? One will be suction, one will be discharge, and one will be charging of refrigerant. Okay, now you can see on the left side, here this part, there will be electrical terminals of that compressor. So this will be that electrical parts. Okay, it will be mounted over here from outside, so that electrical supply is sent to the compressor. And this box, it will cover over here. Okay, so the box will be like this, black color box. Okay, now inside this shell, what is the third part? Here you can see this portion, this will be cylinder. Okay, so this cylinder is there. Here you can see inside, this is the bore. Okay, inside diameter of the cylinder. Then fourth part, this is stator, motor stator coil. Then fifth one, this is rotor. Sixth one, okay, these are, here you can see this is cylinder head, this is gasket. Okay, so gasket, here this is wall. Okay, so wall arrangement will be there. These walls are called reed walls, R-E-E-D. Reed walls are there, then gasket is there, and then cylinder head will be there. Cylinder head is there, and screws are there. Okay, then seventh component you can see. Okay, so seventh one is crankshaft. Then eighth is conrod, connecting rod, and piston. Ninth one, this is oil pickup tube. Tenth one, here you can see four springs are there. So on the bottom side of this shell, there will be oil, and this compressor, it will sit on the springs. Okay, 11, this is internal discharge tube. And 12th one, these are the electrical components. What are the electrical components there? Okay, on this outside of this shell, we usually have a relay and overload protector. Okay, that we will see in the practicals. Okay, now from the top side, if you cut the compressor, okay, if the top cover is removed, and if you see from the top side, okay, here you can see this is counterweight. This counterweight is there. This will be connecting rod, and this is piston. Okay, and this will be the cylinder part where that piston reciprocates. This is cylinder head. Okay, and this is internal discharge tube. Now bottom side of the compressor, you can see these are the windings, stator, this part is the rotor, and in between here you can see this is oil pickup tube. Okay, this will be submerged in the bottom side of the shell from where that oil is picked up. Okay, and here you can see four dampers are there. Okay, so whatever vibration is there because of this reciprocating motion, so that is absorbed by these four springs. Now we will see a small video. Observe that video. From there you will be able to understand the working of this reciprocating compressor, hermetically sealed reciprocating compressor. So suppose this is a refrigerator, and we have all the four components in refrigerator: compressor, condenser, expansion device, evaporator. So we'll see the compressor part now. Okay, so this part, lower part, is stator. Okay, then rotor is there, and this part is crankcase. Okay, this is crankshaft, con rod, connecting rod, and this part will be piston. Then this is head group, cylinder head group is there. Okay, this piston you can see. Okay, now you will be able to see the motion also. So this is discharge. You can see reed valve, it moves behind and forward. Okay, so during suction it opens, closes, then discharge like that. So there will be reciprocating motion. So suction will be there, discharge will be there. This is the stator part, and this is the shell of the hermetically sealed compressor. Okay, so again here in detail that diagram is shown with different parts. So here we have electrical terminals, three terminals are there. This is called CSR. Okay, we will see this CSR connection later on, whatever connection is there on the shell of the compressor. Okay, here bottom side we have oil pickup. Here you can see this is piston, this is cylinder, this is connecting rod. Okay, and wherever oil is required, you can see here oil holes are there. So whatever oil is picked up from the bottom, okay, it is, the lubrication is provided wherever it is required. Okay, now this compressor, it is, we are talking about reciprocating compressor. Okay, this compressor, it is applicable for wide ranges of gas. Okay, like refrigerant can be used, hydrogen, natural gas, etc. Then it can be used for broad capacity range as well. Okay, so usually hermetically sealed compressor, they are used for small capacity. But reciprocating compressor, if you see open type, where we have electrical motor is separate, compressor is separate, and both are connected either by belt or some other arrangement. Okay, so that can be used open type for larger capacity. Okay, and next one is semi-hermetic. Now, what is the semi-hermetic type of compressor? There we can actually open the cylinder head and we can service the walls and piston. Okay, if servicing is required, that can be done in semi-hermetic compressor. Now, what are the limitation of this reciprocating type of compressor? So, first one is low energy efficiency. Now, why this is having low energy efficiency? Because clearance volume. What is this clearance volume? This is suppose cylinder. Here you have walls. Okay, now these walls are not like this. This is just for representation purpose. So, here you will have some clearance volume on the top side, suppose. Okay, so this clearance volume, it is large for reciprocating compressor. So because of that, there are losses. Okay, that gas na discharge, it will expand over here. Okay, and so because of that, what will happen? Here see, piston, this is top dead center, TDC, and this is bottom dead center. So piston, it will reach till this point only. Okay, this location. So this gas na, here there will be some volume. So because of that, there is effect of clearance volume. Okay, so some part here, it will not be compressed. Okay, always this part, their volume will be there. So because of that, now there is net effect on the discharge pressure. Okay. Next disadvantage of reciprocating compressor, it is sensitive to liquid sludging. It is inherent with this design. Now, what do you mean by liquid sludging? Now, what happens is, before compressor, we have evaporator. I'll show you this with the help of a diagram. Suppose this is a compressor. And this compressor inlet, before this we have evaporator. So, this is evaporator and this is compressor. And this is suppose discharge of compressor. Now, at the entry of evaporator, we have liquid plus vapor refrigerant. Now, what happens in vapor compression refrigeration system? All the liquid, it gets converted into vapor. So, at exit of the evaporator, suppose we have vapor. Okay, now, if vapor is there, we don't have any issues. That vapor, it will be sucked in the compressor, compressed, and it will exit the compressor. But suppose, now suppose this example of evaporator is refrigerator and this refrigerator is empty. Refrigerator is empty meaning there is no load in the refrigerator. So this liquid, it will not be able to pick up heat and get converted into vapor. So in such scenario, what will happen at the exit? We will have liquid as well. So liquid will be there and along with that vapor is also there. That liquid will, what will happen? It will enter the compressor and it will fill the compressor. Now there are two things, running cycle and off cycle. What will happen if compressor is running? In that case, this liquid, it will enter through the wall and there will be excessive wearing. Why? Because this oil, it will be diluted because of this liquid refrigerant. Liquid refrigerant, it will mix with the oil and there will be dilution and there will be excess wear and tear. Second case is during off cycle. Now suppose the unit is closed, turned off, then what will happen? This liquid, it will enter the compressor and liquid refrigerant, it will be there in the compressor. And once we restart the unit, what will happen? This liquid, it will strike the walls. Okay, so because of that, what will happen? There is sludging. Now, what is meaning of this sludging? Passage of liquid refrigerant through compressor suction and discharge walls. Because of that, you will be able to hear loud metallic clatter inside the compressor, which is accompanied by vibration of the compressor. Okay, now what is the effect of this sludging? Okay, effect is the walls of the compressor, it might break, okay, because of sludging, piston, crankshaft, walls and connecting wall. They can be damaged. There will be bearing failures as well. Why? Because this liquid refrigerant, it will wash out the oil from the bearing. That is called bearing washout. See, this liquid refrigerant, it is entering the compressor. Now, wherever bearing is there, what will happen? That liquid refrigerant, it will wash out the oil from the bearing. So, because of that is called bearing washout. Friction will occur. Okay, so there will be bearing failure as well because of loss of oil. So, these are the effects of liquid sludging. And this is prominent in reciprocating compressor. Compared with other compressor types, it has larger dimensions and greater weight per unit capacity. Okay, so if you consider, that is why reciprocating compressor, it is not used for very large systems. Okay, we go for some different type of compressors. Then second, the next limitation is difficult to maintain due to complex structure and vibration due to discontinuous gas displacement. What are the applications of this reciprocating compressor? They are used in household, refrigerator and air conditioner. Okay, so if you take example of hermetic type, household refrigerator, freezer is there, air conditioner is there. There also you will be able to find reciprocating hermetically sealed compressor. Residential and commercial air conditioning applications. Now, depending on the size of the system, you can have either open. It is open system. It is open type of compressor. It is used in big systems like ice plant. So ice plant can have open reciprocating compressor. Then semi-hermetic and welded hermetic. Welded hermetic, it is used in small applications. Next compressor is called hermetically sealed, and this type is called scroll compressor. Now understand, this compressor usually height is very big as compared to reciprocating compressor. So bottom side of that scroll compressor, it will be oil sump. Then this part is the suction chamber, and top side you can see red color part. This will be discharge chamber. Okay. Now bottom side, here we have oil pickup tube. Okay. And here we have stator. This will be rotor. Then this is crankshaft. And here we have two scrolls. One is fixed scroll and one is orbiting scroll. Below orbiting scroll, we have Oldham ring. Okay. Now suction port is this side and discharge port, it is from the top side. So if you see a compressor, okay, whose height is bigger, it will be which type of compressor? Scroll compressor. And if you see the scroll compressor, bottom tube, it will be suction, and top tube, it will be discharge. Okay, so now we will see the inside internal construction of this scroll compressor. So the top part, you can see this is stationary scroll, and bottom we have orbiting scroll. Okay, so these are the actual components. Okay, and here you can see this part, this is Oldham ring. Okay, so here you can see the example, this blue color scroll, it is stationary scroll, and red color scroll, it is orbiting scroll. Now exactly how this works, we will see that. Okay, basically refrigerant, it enters from the side. Okay, from here refrigerant enters. Now that refrigerant, it will get trapped in between the stationary scroll, and so this blue color scroll, this is stationary scroll, and red color is orbiting one. Okay, how it orbits, we will see. Okay, now this refrigerant, it gets trapped And here you can see this stationary scroll and orbiting scroll. In between that there is some volume. Okay, and that volume na, here you can see there is crescent shape, and that shape it goes on reducing, and finally from the center if you see there will be discharge from the top side of the compressor. So vapor, it enters from the circumference of the scroll. Okay, it will enter from this side, and then stationary scroll is there, orbiting scroll is there, constantly this crescent shape it goes on reducing, and finally from the center there will be discharge. It's like that. Okay, so blue color scroll is stationary one and red one is orbiting. Now see this video. Here you can see this shaft, it is rotating. Okay, there will be a winding below, and here you can see this is the orbiting scroll. Okay, it is orbiting. This is basically eccentric arrangement. Okay, here you can see this shaft is, it is eccentric. Okay, because of that there will be a orbiting motion. Okay, and below this orbiting scroll there will be Oldham ring. Okay, now here you can see this white color is the stationary scroll and gray color it is orbiting scroll. Now if you see this volume between the stationary and orbiting scroll, it is of crescent shape. Okay, moon ka shape rehta na, crescent waisa shape hai wahan pe. So here you can see refrigerant, it enters from the circumference, and that shape na, it inside the volume, okay, whatever volume is there it goes on reducing, and because of that there is constantly compression. So here you can see that it is highlighted by that gray color. Okay, so this is the crescent shape, and in between this refrigerant is there. Now here it becomes darker. Okay, you can see from A we are going to L, A B C D E F G H I J K L. Okay, so it is in sequence. So here you can see this dark part, here the volume is continuously reducing, so that vapor it is pressurized, and finally there will be discharge from the center. So we'll see the video of this. Okay, this black scroll, it is stationary one, and red color it is orbiting one. So here you can see this shape, it is crescent shape. Okay, now see this is compression. Okay, here it is trapped. We'll see this again. Okay, observe this. Here refrigerant is trapped. Now this refrigerant, it is traveling in this direction inside. Okay, its volume is reducing, and finally from here it will enter in this direction, and from center it will discharge. Okay, once it is trapped now, it can go in this direction only, it will discharge from center only. Okay, you can observe this again. Okay, from here refrigerant enters, then it is trapped. Okay, here you can see there is constantly covering is there. Okay, it will enter from here and discharge from center only. Okay, one more video we will see. So here you can see the height of the compressor, it is more. Okay, this is suction and this one is delivery, upper one. Okay, bottom side here we will have oil. This is stator and rotor. Now observe this, this part it is Oldham ring. Okay, upper part there will be stationary scroll, and below that there will be orbiting scroll. You will be able to see, it will be an exploded view, so observe that properly. Okay, so here you can see from the periphery, that vapor, low pressure, low temperature refrigerant, it enters, and there is a crescent shape. Here you can see crescent shapes are formed, and that refrigerant gets trapped in between stationary and orbiting scroll, and finally there is discharge from the center. Okay, here you can see from center there will be discharge. Okay, and from the side view it will be like this. Now we will see the internal construction. Okay, so from the top this is discharge. Now see the internal construction. Okay, so this top side, this will be stationary scroll. This one, it is orbiting scroll. Okay, so if you recall that previous slide, this one, okay, this is stationary scroll and this one is orbiting scroll. Okay, so upper one is stationary one, this one is orbiting, and this one, okay, this one is orbiting scroll, this is Oldham ring. Because of that we get orbiting motion, and bottom we have a shaft which is rotating this, which is trying to rotate this. But here you can see on the orbiting scroll there is a groove, and on the Oldham ring here you can see there is a projection. So this projection, it will reciprocate inside this slot. Okay, and because of that you get orbiting motion. Understand this properly. See, this lower orbiting scroll, it has a slot over here, and on the Oldham ring there is a projection. This projection, it will go inside this slot, and because of that there will be orbiting motion of this lower scroll. Now observe this. Okay, this is a bit eccentric. This is the Oldham ring, this part, this is orbiting scroll. Okay, now see this, this is the Oldham ring, and there is a projection. That projection fits inside this orbiting scroll. Okay, so here there is a slot, so because of that the lower scroll, it has orbiting motion. See this now, and this is the stationary scroll. So you can see Oldham ring and orbiting scroll motion. So again same thing is shown. This is the suction, and from center there will be discharge. So we have seen reciprocating compressor, and now we have seen scroll compressor. So what are the advantages and limitations? Advantages of scroll compressor, we will see that. There are large suction and discharge ports. Because of that, what happens, there is reduces the pressure loss during suction and discharge. Okay, so since the ports are large, it reduces the pressure loss. Second thing is, there is physical separation of suction and compression. So you, if you see the video or diagram, suction refrigerant and whatever discharge is there after compression, discharge is there. So that suction and discharge, there is no contact. So there will not be any heat transfer between the suction and the discharge gas. Okay, but if you see the reciprocating, same suction and same delivery is there. Okay, so they are in contact. Okay, so there will be heat transfer between the suction and discharge gas. Okay, so same thing is written, physical separation of suction and compression reduce heat transfer to suction gas, leading to high volumetric efficiency. Volumetric efficiency is high due to very low re-expansion loss. Now what happens if you see reciprocating compressor? okay, this is clearance volume. Now when piston it moves in downward direction, there will be re-expansion of this vapor. Because of that, there are losses which are called re-expansion losses. Okay, there is no such thing in case of scroll compressor. So volumetric efficiency is high due to low re-expansion loss and continuous flow over wide range of operating condition. These compressors have high efficiency, low noise and vibration as compared to reciprocating compressor. Why? Because there is no reciprocating motion. Then this is compact with minimum number of moving parts. What is the application? This compressor type is normally used for commercial air conditioning and refrigeration application, which requires compressor capacity from 5 to 10 tons. Okay, now here remember that all these different type of compressors are basically selected based on the tons of refrigeration. Okay, if you see hermetically sealed compressor, they are used for low tonnage. Okay, then scroll compressors, they are used from 5 ton to 10 ton capacity. Obviously here this capacity, whatever is written over here, okay, it can change a bit. Okay, but basically you will understand what is the range, what is the tonnage for which we use scroll compressor. Next we will see again hermetically sealed. Here you can see this is compressor hermetically sealed. Okay, a shell is there. Inside this we will have a compressor and motor as well. This is rotary compressor. Okay, now there are two types. One is fixed vane or blade. Okay, so this is fixed vane or blade type rolling piston rotary compressor. There is one more compressor which is called sliding vane rotary compressor, that we will see after this. So what is this type? It is rolling piston stationary vane type rotary compressor. Okay, here vane exactly it is not stationary. Okay, it is moving up and down, but it is not rotating. Okay, here the vane or blade, it is not rotating. Okay, now understand this diagram. On the left side, here you can see one shell is there. This shell, it is called suction accumulator. Now we have seen before, there is a disadvantage of reciprocating compressor. What is that? It is prone to sludging. To prevent sludging, we use a device which is called suction accumulator. So same thing is shown over here. For rotary compressor, we are using a suction accumulator. So this left side, small shell, it is suction accumulator. Why is this used? Whatever evaporator is there, okay, this is, it is like this. Evaporator is over here. Evaporator outlet, it is connected where? To the accumulator. Suppose load in the evaporator is less, so we might get liquid at the exit of the evaporator. Now to prevent damage to the compressor, this liquid needs to be converted into vapor. That is the function of this suction accumulator. It will prevent liquid refrigerant from entering the compressor. How it is done, we will see. Okay, now refrigerant, it will enter here. So refrigerant from evaporator outlet, okay, this is evaporator. Refrigerant from evaporator outlet, it enters the suction accumulator. This is suction accumulator. At the exit of the accumulator, we will have refrigerant vapor. From exit of the accumulator, it enters the rotary compressor. So here there will be rotary compressor. Now we will see internal construction. Okay, so this is the hermetically sealed rotary compressor. On the bottom side, there will be oil chamber. Here you can see this is suction accumulator. Okay, and on the bottom side, so here you can see there is a tube. Here also there is a tube, and this tube has a small hole on the bottom side that is called bleed hole. What is that? We will see again in the upcoming slides. okay, and there is a small filter over here. It is called suction filter. So basically, there is a tube over here. That liquid, it will fall on a plate over here, and there is a filter also, suction filter. And below this, there is a tube again. And here we have a bleed hole. This is about suction accumulator. Now from here, the vapor, it will enter the rotary compressor. So this part will be rotary compressor. Here we have stator winding, and this is the rotor part. Bottom side we have oil chamber, and this part will be the compressor part. Okay, and here you can see to the shell we have some holes. So these, through these holes, there will be a rubber arrangement, and there will be bolt, and this compressor, it is fitted on the surface. Okay, so there will be a bolt over here, and there will be some isolators, rubber isolators, to prevent the vibration. Okay, now we will see upper part of the suction accumulator. Okay, now this part here, there will be evaporator. From evaporator, this is the outlet, and this is the suction accumulator. Now suppose liquid, it is exiting the evaporator. Suppose there is flooding, there is no enough load on the evaporator, so we will have liquid. That liquid, it will enter the suction accumulator. So this is the shell of the accumulator. Now here you can see that tube is over, and this material you can see over here, this is that suction filter. Okay, here you can see this is suction filter, and below the filter there is a plate. So there is a plate like this, and on the plate there are holes like this. Okay, now exactly below this plate there is a tube. Now what happens is, this liquid, it will enter from here, it will fall on this plate. Now if you see the plate, center part of the plate, material is there, and below that exactly we have a tube. So from the center, that liquid cannot directly enter this tube. Okay, it cannot enter. Why? Because here material is there at the center. So what will happen, this liquid, it will fall on this suction filter, and the area will increase. Okay, that liquid refrigerant, it will travel in this way. Okay, and then through this hole, it will fall in this downward direction like this, but it will not enter this vertical tube. Okay, so understand this properly. Liquid from the evaporator, it comes over here, it will fall on this circular plate, but center, we don't have hole, so it cannot directly enter this vertical tube. Okay, so that liquid, it will be first filtered, and then through this hole it will fall inside the suction accumulator. So this is the upper part. Now we will see bottom part. On the bottom side, here you can see what is there, that whatever liquid is falling, it will accumulate over here. Now basically what happens, when compressor is working, that oil in the compressor, it will also travel throughout the system. So along with refrigerant, that oil from compressor, it will go to condenser, it will go to expansion device, it will go to evaporator, and from evaporator it will come back where, in the suction accumulator. So oil will accumulate on the bottom side, and on the upper side there will be liquid refrigerant. Why? Because oil will be heavier. And on the bottom side here you can see, this is bleed hole. Okay, this is bleed hole, from where oil, it will bleed and go back to the compressor. Why? Because in compressor that oil is required. Where is lubrication required? In compressor. So that is why whatever oil, it is traveling throughout the system, it again comes to the suction accumulator, and there is a bleed hole from where that oil again goes back to the compressor. Now throughout the height of the accumulator, this liquid will be filled. Okay, so I'll go back to the previous slide. So here you can see the height of the accumulator. Suppose liquid is filled till this height, so liquid won't be able to directly enter this vertical tube. Now what happens is, atmosphere, it is at higher temperature and compressor is nearby. Here there is compressor. So because of that, what will happen? This compressor surface is hot. Also we are surrounding. So because of that, this liquid refrigerant inside the accumulator, it will get heated up. It will get converted into vapor. This vapor now, it will enter the tube. So basically, liquid will be filled over here. That liquid, it will take the heat from surrounding, from compressor, and it will vaporize. Now this vapor, it will travel in this way and enter this tube. And from this tube, it will travel in downward direction. Okay, like this. And it will enter the compressor. Okay, so from here, it will travel in downward direction and it will enter the compressor. So from suction, there will be a suction filter. Okay, liquid refrigerant, it will fill this. Okay, so this will be the height. Bottom side, there will be oil. That oil, it will go through this bleed hole to the compressor again. Okay, then this refrigerant which is filled over here, liquid, it will pick up the heat from surrounding and from the compressor, and it will vaporize, and from here the vapor, it will travel in this way and go to the compressor. Okay, now see the internal construction of this rolling piston type rotary compressor. So here you can see a spring is there and a vane is there. It is called vane or blade. So because of that, this vane, it can slide inside this part. Okay, and here there will be a suction port. Here there will be a suction port. We will see in next slide. And here you can see this part. It is discharge port. Okay, so here there will be suction port and here this is discharge port. Okay, now in this diagram everything is visible. So this outer one, this is cylindrical housing. Now after the accumulator, this is the suction port. Here you can see this part. This is suction port. So vapor will enter from here. Now here you can see this part. Okay, this will be the chamber where that suction gas is there. Okay, it is in between this sliding vane, cylindrical housing, and this is the rolling piston. Okay, now once this rolling piston rolls, it will cover up the suction port. Okay, and on this side, there will be increase of pressure that we will see in the next slide. Okay, so this is sliding vane. Here there is a spring. This is a suction port. This is cylindrical housing. And this is a discharge port. Okay, so same thing here you can see. Now understand the working here. Okay, this is discharge valve. Okay, like this there will be discharge. That volume, it goes on reducing. And this side there will be suction. Okay, this is suction port, this is discharge port. From here the vapor will enter inside. Okay, this is the vapor which has entered. Okay, now suction will go on. Okay, so this will be suction. Here you can see this will be the vapor part which is sucked. Okay, now here you can see it will be filled completely. So this will be vapor filled during the suction stroke. Now second rotation, discharge port is closed. Here we have cylindrical housing and this is rolling piston. So continuously this volume is reducing, so pressure will increase. Okay, so observe that. So here you can see now constantly volume is reducing, so here pressure will increase. And once the pressure is more than whatever the preset discharge port is there, this port will open and high pressure vapor, it will exit the compressor. Okay, so now you will see this port it will open and this is discharge. So during one rotation we have suction and during second rotation we have discharge. So we will stop over here and continue with the compressors in next lecture.